In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Greetings, beloved of God, and welcome. Today is Thursday, the 2nd of September 2021. It is Thursday of the 22nd week in Ordinary Time, Church Year B. You are listening to Catholic Meditation. I am Reverend Father Blessed Amba Njume, welcoming you to today's edition of our program. Good morning, and thanks for joining us. Let us pray. God of might, giver of every good gift, put into our hearts the love of your name, so that by deepening our sense of reverence, you may nurture in us what is good, and by your watchful care, keep safe what you have nurtured. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. The first reading is taken from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians, chapter 1, verses 9 to 14. The responsorial psalm is taken from Psalm 98. The response to the psalm is, "The Lord has made known his salvation." The Gospel is taken from St. Luke, chapter 5, verses 1 to 11. I read from the Gospel. At that time, while the people pressed upon Jesus to hear the word of God, he was standing by the lake of Gennesaret, and he saw two boats by the lake, but the fishermen had gone out of them and were washing their nets. Getting into one of the boats, which was Simon's, he asked him to put out a little from the land. And he sat down and taught the people from the boat. And when he had ceased speaking, he said to Simon, "Put out into the deep and let down your nets for a catch." And Simon answered, "Master, we toiled all night and took nothing, but at your word, I will let down the nets." And when they had done this, they enclosed a great shoal of fish, and as their nets were breaking, they beckoned to their partners in the other boat to come and help them. And they came and filled both the boats, so that they began to sink. But when Simon Peter saw it, he fell down at Jesus' knees, saying, "Depart from me, for I am a sinful man, O Lord." For he was astonished, and all that were with him, at the catch of fish which they had taken. And so also were James and John, sons of Zebedee, who were partners with Simon. And Jesus said to Simon, "Do not be afraid. Henceforth you will be catching men." And when they had brought their boats to land, they left everything and followed him. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. The theme for today's meditation is listen to God and trust His word. Listen to God and trust His word. Beloved of God, today's gospel episode happened by the lake of Genesaret, and it teaches us one great lesson. From the episode, we learn never to argue with God, but to trust His every word, because He is the master in every domain and sphere of life. No one can claim to know better than Jesus. In every field, in every domain, He is the master. In cookery, He is the master chef. In football, He is the goal getter. Even in fishing, He is the master fisherman. The apostles were fishermen by profession, yet their skill failed them this time when, despite an all-night attempt, they caught nothing. So you see that truly it is not always that skill is proficient enough. After a disappointing night, they were all out of their boats, cleaning their nets. Then Jesus showed up. He instructed them, "Put out your nets into the deep," that is, spread out your nets where the water is deepest. Fishermen will tell you, to get a good catch, fishing is best done at night. And not only at night, when you spread your nets where the water is deepest. But this is what Peter and the others had done all night, yet they caught nothing. Peter and his companions surely laughed in their hearts when Jesus told them to put out into the deep. So what did Jesus imply? That they had not done all that all night? Or that they did not know what to do? They were the masters. Jesus was a carpenter. And how could He claim to know better than they, fishermen, who had been fishing all their lives? Dear friend in Christ, imagine you baking a cake or cooking and it is not coming out as you planned, and your little girl walks up to you and tells you a proposal that you reduce the heat of the fire. You may look at her and sigh in your heart and say to yourself, the heat of the fire is not the issue here. It is not today I started baking or cooking and with the same intensity of heat or even greater. You may think she has no point. By trying it, you may just discover and realize that had been the problem all along. We are never too old to learn, and we can still take advice from others in different domains that can be of help to us in our own field of work. Because Peter thought he knew better than Jesus, he argued his master. I am the fisherman here, and the master in the field. I have done all what you have said, yet it yielded no fruit. Well, if you say so, let me just try again. And when he did, the catch was stupendous. I guess even before Peter made the try, he was just doing it for curiosity's sake. Let me just do it to please him. But this is what we have done all night and caught nothing. And after the catch, Peter went on his knees and told the master, "Get away from me, Lord, I am a sinful man." Why did Peter say this? He saw how stupid he was. He had been arguing the master. How could he be arguing the master? How could he think he knew better than the master? And so when he saw just how stupid and foolish he had been, he went down on his knees and said, "Get away from me, Lord. I am a sinful man." Beloved of God, how does the gospel apply to our lives? Many times you and I have found ourselves arguing with Jesus, perhaps even in our prayers. Or you go to meet a priest for counseling or advice, and you find yourself telling him, "Father, I have done all what you are saying." Jesus did not ask the apostles to do anything extraordinary. It was the same thing they had been doing, but this time they did the same thing. But there was a difference. They added a little more faith. A little more faith changed the entire narrative. So, beloved, Stop arguing with Jesus or thinking you know better than him. Remember, he is the master. We have found ourselves too like the apostles, almost disappointed with God and with ourselves, almost disappointed with life, perhaps because of sickness. You have gone to one hospital, to another. You have done all what friends have told you to do. You have taken one medication after the other, yet there seems to be no difference. It could be childlessness. You have done all what the doctors have said. You have taken all kinds of prescriptions, yet the children seem not to come. It could be joblessness. What have you not done to get a job, but it seems not to come? And you are at that point like the apostles, telling the master, what have we not done? Dear friends, go back to the words of Peter. But if you say so, this is what Peter said, and the master is telling you. So do not say, I have done this, I have done that, and I don't know exactly what else to do. Jesus tells you today, do the same things you have been doing, but with a little more faith. Peter cast the nets, but with a little more faith, into the same waters. What they had done all night but caught nothing, this time, with just a little more faith, the catch was different. So, dear friend, the catch will be different for you too if you add just a little more faith to the normal things you have been doing always. Do you know why the apostles did the same thing, that is casting their nets, but this time around, why they caught more fish? Let us return to the story. It is because they had first spent some time to listen to God's word. I guess that night when they got into the boats, because they thought they were masters of their field, they thought they could catch. And perhaps they pushed Jesus away. They pushed prayer away. When Jesus appeared at the scene, he invited them. He knew they had caught nothing. He did not first tell them to cast the nets. No, he used those boats, preached the word, and after the people had listened to him, then he said, cast your nets into the deep. Put God first in everything and your results will be different. It is not about how much you know. It is not about how masterful you know your work. Let me let you know. Your proficiency, your every talent without God's efficiency equals deficiency. God is not the last resort when all else have failed, but he is the very beginning and initiator of every project. If you invite him at the beginning of everything, you will never know failure. This is a lesson he teaches us. Always listen to his word and do exactly what he says. Invite him at the beginning of every project and you will make a great catch that will surprise even yourself. Amen. Catholic meditation with me, Father Blessed. The Lord be with you. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son and the Holy Spirit come on you and remain with you forever.